Hello friends and my dear students, welcome back to my channel Phoenix Physics. Today we are going to learn measurement of mass. What is mass? Mass of the substance is the amount of matter present in it. For example, I am having 10 kg sugar. Okay, in physics I can tell this sugar is matter. Why? Because this sugar occupies some space. It has some mass. So we can call this sugar as a matter. What about this 10 kg? This is nothing but our mass. So in general we can say mass of the substance is the amount of matter present in it. Up to this clear? Next one, in your lower section you have studied a lot about mass. You know that mass is the one of the basic property of matter. It does not depend on temperature, pressure, then location of an object in space. For example, if an object has a mass of 10 kg on Earth, means it would have the same mass, that is same 10 kg on moon. So mass does not depends on the location of an object. Third point is mass is constant. And you know that mass is a scalar quantity. What is scalar quantity? Scalar means it has magnitude. Okay, so here this 10 is our magnitude. So mass is a scalar quantity. Then fifth point is mass of an object cannot be zero. These are all the properties of mass. So mass is the basic property of matter. It does not depend on temperature, pressure and location of an object. Then mass is constant everywhere. It is a scalar quantity, which means it has only magnitude. Then mass of an object cannot be zero. So mass of a body is defined as the quantity of matter contained in a body. Up to this clear? Next one is weight. Is mass same as weight? No. Why? What is weight? Weight is the force exerted by the gravity on the object. So weight is not as same as mass. Up to this clear? Then what about the SI unit of mass? The SI unit is kilogram. Even though we usually talk about weight in kilogram, it should be measured in Newton. Okay, which means in practical day-to-day life we normally say weight is in kilogram, right? So but actually in physics the unit of weight is Newton. What is Newton? It is nothing but unit of force. Okay, up to this clear? You know that the SI unit of mass is kilogram. In our previous video, we discussed about the fundamental quantities and the definition for 1 kilogram. I hope you know that. So, the International Bureau of Weight and Measures, BIPM, supplied the standard prototype of kilogram. prototype of kilogram into all other countries and laboratories. In India, the standard prototype of kilogram is available at National Physical Laboratory. In New Delhi, that is NPL. Okay, so you know that this prototype of 1 kilogram cylinder is made up of platinum and iridium alloy in the ratio 9:1. So 9:1, and you know that the height of the cylinder is equal to the diameter of the cylinder. Which is nothing but 3.9 centimeter. Okay, so these things we discussed earlier. Okay, now tell me, why do we use this platinum and iridium alloy? Because this metals have high density and corrosion resistance. Which means it does not oxidize under normal condition. Okay, so that is why we are using platinum and iridium alloy. Okay, up to this clear? Have you heard about CSL? What is CSL? CSL is nothing but Chandrasekhar Limited. You know that SI unit of mass is kilogram, then what is the CSL? CSL is nothing but Chandrasekhar Limited. It is a large practical unit of mass. So one CSL is equal to 1.4 times of mass of the sun. So SI unit of mass is kilogram. So CSL is nothing but Chandrasekhar Limit. This is a large practical unit of mass, and one CSL is equal to 1.4 times of mass of the sun. Next one is range of mass. You know that the mass of the electron is 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kilogram, and mass of the known universe, why I am saying mass of the known universe, because universe is infinite. Okay, so mass of the known universe (10^55 kg). In between, so many values are given, please go through the tabular column. How do you measure mass? In our day-to-day life, we can use common balance, electronic balance, and spring balance to measure mass. Okay, I hope you know that. Here, in common balance, we are just comparing the masses. How in one pan we are putting the weight, another pan we are putting some sugar or grocery item. Okay, we are just comparing the two masses. Okay, what about electronic balance? It is same as common balance. Here the display is in the digital form. Okay, what about spring balance? I hope you know that. Suppose if you want to weigh old newspaper, the shopkeeper use spring balance to weigh the old newspaper, right? So in our day-to-day life, we are using these three: common balance, electronic balance, and spring balance. Suppose if you want to measure larger masses like planet, star, etc. How do you measure larger masses? By gravitational method. Okay. Suppose if you want to measure atomic, that is smaller masses, like atomic or subatomic particle, we can use mass spectrometer. From that mass spectrometer, we can get mass spectrograph. Based on the mass spectrograph, we can measure the masses of atomic and subatomic particle. So, larger mass means gravitational method, smaller masses means mass spectrometer. Up to this clear? This is Bainbridge mass spectrometer. Using this mass spectrometer, we can measure the mass of an ionized particle. Okay? Here, I have taken the sample. The sample is in the form of solid or liquid. Heat the sample. After heating the sample, it becomes vapor. So, vapor or gaseous state. So, allow this gas to enter into the chamber. Here, I have electron gun. This electron gun bombarded the gas molecules. Due to this bombardment, knock off electrons from the atoms and it can ionize the atoms. So due to this bombardment, some of the particles are charged. So the charged particles enter into the electric field. Here we can set the electric field manually, and this, due to this electric field, this charged ions accelerate towards this chamber. Okay, so after the acceleration, the rapid moving ions enter into the magnetic field. Here I have strong magnetic field. This magnetic field bend the path of the ionized particle and deflect the particles in a semicircular path. Ions of different masses have different semicircular path and different radius. Why I am saying different radius? Suppose this M1 mass has the radius R1 and the M2 mass has the radius R2. Okay. So, using this formula, what is the formula? M is equal to RB squared Q by E. So, R is nothing but radius of the circular path. B is our magnetic field. Q is our charge of the particle. Then E is our electric field. If you know the value, substitute, you can get the mass of the ionized particle. Up to this clear? So finally the output will be like this. M1, M2. This is called mass spectrograph. Okay. So based on that, we can calculate the mass of the smallest particle. This is one of the example to measure smaller masses. I hope this video is useful to you. If you like my video, please share and subscribe my video.